Hello, everybody. Welcome to the Dennis Prager Show. I have a guest here, not in studio, unfortunately, but as most cases, by phone. He's written a very interesting book. As you know, folks, I am somewhat preoccupied with the liberal-conservative, left-right distinctions and how each understands the other. So listen to this book. This is the title, Republican Like Me, How I Left the Liberal Bubble and Learned to Love the Right. And he has the credentials to speak about the liberal bubble because he was formerly the CEO of NPR National Public Radio. His name is Ken Stern, currently president of Palisades Media Ventures. Ken Stern, welcome to the Dennis Prager Show.
Thank you, Dennis. Thanks for having me on the show.
Certainly. So, do you stand by that there is a liberal bubble?
There are all sorts of bubbles in this country. I mean, one of the things that got me to write this book is that in this world, we're increasingly, on both sides, living in our own bubbles. And mine happened to be a liberal bubble, a liberal one. So Democrats live with Democrats, Republicans live with Republicans, Democrats have their own media, Republicans have their own media. And it's increasingly easy in this country of ours to spend all of our time talking to people who agree with us. And I live in a 94% Democratic ward in Washington, D.C., a 100% Democratic household. And I wanted to, Atticus Finch said in To Kill a Mockingbird, if you want to understand someone, you have to see things from their point of view. And that's what the book about, trying to see things from a different point of view.
Well, I salute you for that, and I mean that completely, 100% sincerely. It's I had a guy on. He wrote a book on nothing to do with left-right, but he was a New York liberal, and he was on my shows many years ago. He wrote a book on the Kennedy assassination. I thought it was an excellent book. And anyway, I talked to authors about all sorts of things, and the issue arose, and I asked him, so have you ever had lunch with a Republican? Because he lives in Manhattan.
Yeah.
and to his great credit, he said no. So I assume that resonates with you.
It does. You know, the Washington Post ran this extraordinary poll during the run-up to the last election, to the 2016 election. And it was a poll in Virginia. A purple state that ended up going for Hillary Clinton by just a couple points. And they asked Clinton supporters, do you have any close personal friends or family members who could support Trump? And they asked the same thing of Trump supporters. And, you know, this is an evenly divided state. And, you know, for most people, family members and close personal friends is a pretty big group. And about 60% of people said they didn't have anyone on the other side, who was going to vote for the other side in that category. I mean, it's sort of an extraordinary thing. We've really divided ourselves. I mean, it's not just lunch, it's who we talk to.
All right, I'm a little suspicious. Forgive me, Ken, but I'm a little suspicious of that poll.
Yeah.
Because they lumped them together. I don't know of a single Trump voter who does not have a Clinton voter in their extended family. So it's a very odd poll that they would have taken.
They actually asked the question of both sides. I mean, so they didn't report it as one number. They reported that as Trump voters who knew Clinton, you know, who knew Clinton, and then also a separate number for Clinton voters. And they're a little different. In fact, as you suspect, the Clinton voters number was a little bit higher, but they were both over 50%. It was
right.
Really exciting.
All right. Well, okay. And whether one buys it or not, it's not the key issue.
Yeah.
So what did you learn coming to meet us?
So, you know, just a lot. So I spent almost 18 months outside my liberal bubble, spending time in evangelical churches, gun shows, Pikeville, spending time in Pikeville, Kentucky, in the middle of eastern Kentucky coal country, talking to conservative academics, And I learned a ton. I mean, I just a couple things I learned. One is I learned I was wrong on a number of issues because I built it around some issues that I thought I didn't know a lot about, but thought I had to be right on, like gun rights and gun control. I also learned that the American people are sort of incredibly moderate people once you get to face to face with them. I mean, you can't tell in sort of this very loud social media world where everyone hates everyone, everyone is constantly accusing the other. But when you get face-to-face to people, and actually look at the data as well, people actually tend to sort of gravitate towards the middle. They find nuance, which we don't recognize very much in this world, and that was extraordinarily impressive for me to see.
Well, did you, by the way, in the course of your studying, sort of as an anthropologist, those of us to the right of you, Did you spend time listening to conservative talk radio?
I did. I spent one of the things getting out of it, so it's not just a media bubble. It's just not sort of a who talked to bubble. It's who you listen to bubble. So I changed my media mix. I couldn't quite give up the New York Times and the Washington Post, but I spent time with Fox. I spent time with conservative talk radio. I spent time with
Did you read the one? All right, good. All right, we got a lot more. A prominent liberal decided to leave the liberal bubble, those are his words, to his great credit, I might add, and see what we're like. He is Ken Stern, former CEO of NPR, National Public Radio. The subtitle of the book, Republican Like Me, is How I Left the Liberal Bubble and Learned to Love the Right. Now, it's a little overstated, I suspect, because you may love us, but you're not one of us. Is that fair to say?
That's right. So the love the right is, in my mind, the same as sort of Lincoln's bonds of affection, the notion that we have a community across political, in that case, geographic lines. So I don't agree with everything. I learned a lot. I don't agree with everything I heard or learned. But I really learned to admire a lot of the people who I'd met along the way, people who are really making great contributions to the community. I'm honored to know them. That's the love. It's not agreement, but it is a love of a sort of a fraternal affection.
So when you hear from fellow liberals or leftists, and I always divide between the two,
yep.
But when you hear from them that we on the right are endemically what I call six herbs, sexist, intolerant, xenophobic, homophobic, Islamophobic, racist, and bigoted.
Sexist, intolerant, xenophobic, homophobic,
Islamophobic, racist, bigoted, old right-wing white guys.
How do you react?
So I think the one thing that makes me most angry in this political war of ours is how we demagogue the people on this side. So when I hear, you know, the deplorables, the people clinging to their guns and religion, the, you know, that they are, they hate gays or are white nationalists, describing, you know, tens of millions of people that way, makes me very angry because that's not who I met or who I know from the right.
Right. So here is my charge, because I do know I don't live in a conservative bubble. A, I'm Jewish, so it's not possible.
Yeah.
B, I was a Democrat till Ronald Reagan. Went to Columbia, surrounded by people who were liberal Democrats, if not actual leftists. And to this day, I read more. I read the New York Review of Books every issue, and the New York Times every day, and the Washington Post and the L.A. Times. It's impossible for me to avoid it. So I claim to my audience, and tell me how you react to this, that we know you far better than you folks know us.
Yeah, I think that's true. So I've heard that a lot. A lot of people say that to me, especially from conservative media. And I think there's a certain truth to it, right? So you can't really know what's going on in the world without reading the New York Times following the mainstream media. So, yeah, I think that's true. I think it's true just because of the liberal leftist influence on media, and that's news media and cultural media as well. But I do think, I mean, so I agree with you up to a point, which is I do think people also are in a conservative bubble, and that's not everyone and everywhere, but I think it's more and more opportunity to absorb your own media, to live in states in which or communities which are increasingly red. And one of the things is called the Big Sort. We're actually physically dividing ourselves along party lines. So I think the bubbles, maybe that the liberal bubble's a little thicker, but they're both getting too thick for my case.
Mm-hmm. And you live in a 94% Democratic district, you mentioned to me?
Yep, yeah. Mount Pleasant neighborhood in Washington, D.C. More votes for the Green Party candidate than for Donald Trump last time around.
Wow. You're right. That really does paint the picture, I must admit. So right now, I'm curious. Do you feel more distant, not emotionally, I'm not talking emotions, more distant philosophically from the left? Because I hear you as a liberal, not a leftist. So
yeah.
Do you feel, and I'll give you a real life example. Alan Dershowitz, whom I know very well, and I just was with in Manhattan. So he said, and he said it on camera, he didn't just say this privately, that he is much more afraid of the left than of the right. And this is a Clinton-supporting, lifelong liberal professor of law at Harvard. And so I'm curious, do you fear the right or the left more in America?
It's an interesting question. I find it hard to give a distinctive answer because I feel alienated from both sides now. That's sort of the consequences of my journey, which is I don't think either party and, you know, the leftists who control the Democratic Party and the various types of conservatives who control the Republican Party now adequately represent either me or most Americans. I think I've become part of the middle that's suspicious of both sides. I'm not sure who poses a bigger danger. I think neither of them are doing a good job of leading the country, and wonder whether these are the right parties for the future.
If Mitt Romney had run against Hillary Clinton, who would you have voted for?
I would have voted for Mitt Romney.
Very interesting. We'll be back in a moment. The book is Republican Like Me. Ken Stern, former CEO of NPR. Final segment here with a man who did a noble thing. A liberal who decided to immerse himself for some time among conservatives. Former CEO of NPR. Ken Stern. The book is called Republican Like Me, How I Left the Liberal Bubble and Learned to Love the Right. How have folks on the left responded to your book?
So I think one of the dispiriting things about America is how people want to judge a book by its cover. So I have had a lot of people who have not read the book on the left say that if I love the right, I must be white supremacist or hate gays. I've lost my lifetime membership in the public radio conference. So I think that's been a little bit of, I mean, people have read it, have liked it and want to engage with me, but I've seen the nastiness of some people on the left. It's a little dispiriting.
Is there a non-nasty left? I think it's redundant.
Yeah, of course there is.
Where are they? Are they on the New York Times opinion page? Did you ever read Charles Blow?
Yeah, so I think there are both people in media, but more important to me, I mean, just sort of average people, we would call them the left or liberals or Democrats, who have engaged with it. I mean, some of my old friends who I've thought of as being somewhat intolerant of others, I have a few people in mind, read it and really liked it, and I think opened their eyes. And I that's why I wrote the book. And
well, I really do. I level with people all the time, and I really do respect the fact that you did that. I did my own traveling from my liberal democratic origins in New York, and I came to love the right, and not only its people but its thinking. But in any event, I do recommend your book.
Thank you.
I'm happy that people like you exist. And good luck in your future endeavors.
Thank you for having me on the show, Dennis. I enjoyed it.
Thank you, sir.